The Science of Wear.
El último ponente de esta tarde, que no por ello menos importante, de hecho traen una solución, yo ya la he visto, bastante impactante, es Nicolai, igual la habéis visto, están por aquí fuera, están patrocinando la conferencia, es de L3 Harris, además de un proveedor de imágenes de procedentes de sensores remotos, imágenes satélite, imágenes aéreas, también han desarrollado una solución para que llegue a hacer análisis predictivo de cara al mantenimiento de infraestructuras. Yo creo que es interesante, os lo va a contar, además tienes un...
Do you have a small video also to show them?
Yeah. Yeah, buenas tardes. My name is Nicolai Holzer from Harris. Apologies, I don't speak Spanish and it's the last presentation of the day, but I try to speak slowly. I'm working for a company which is called L3 Harris. We are partner with S3 Spain, and thanks in particular for having the opportunity to speak here in this room about our utility solutions. Here, based on remote sensing, based on image data, for, in particular, the transmission, distribution, electricity operators. Maybe at the beginning, some more information of who we are, and this infographic is giving a good overview of the general business. We at L3 Harris, we are a large technology provider based in the US. Harris recently merged with a company called L3, now having 15,000 employees and revenue of about 17 billion, operating in 113 countries. For over 30 years, part of the business, which is a geospatial business that I am representing, and my colleague James Slater, that is just standing here in the back as well, we are doing image science for over 30 years, and maybe some of you know our products Envy, SARSCAPE, IDL. These are products widely used to extract information from satellite data, airborne data, UAV data to derive information. Here in this infographic, you can see how this technology can be used in the field of utilities. You see some examples here, asset management, vegetation management, storm damage assessment. Just thinking here, as I read in the news, the large forest fires that are currently happening in California, large parts of California are cut off from electricity due to danger, due to the forest fires that are currently happening. And also here, image data and remote sensing can be very valuable. Thinking about how currently utilities are operating their assets, there are different challenges and different drivers. Challenges are, for instance, that the margins are less and less. There needs to optimize costs, improve safety, and of course, ensure reliability and customer satisfaction. The traditional inspections that are nowadays typically still based with visual inspections from the ground, or maybe also from the helicopter, but also visual inspections. This is time consuming and also dangerous. And also often a comprehensive picture of the data itself is missing, and coherent systems are missing that can manage that large amount of image data. It's a big data problem. Yeah, and UAVs are emerging, but the technology is maybe still not major. Uncertainties in terms of the regulations. So there are potentials, but it's still unclear how such could be used. And here, remote sensing technology combined with geospatial analytics can help to optimize costs, increase efficiency, also improve safety, and maintain reliability of the system. Now, how can we address these? And we at Harris, we developed a new product, which is called Amplify. And this product is built based on our technology that is in place for decades, that is particularly in place at the defense domain. We are also, at the end, a large US-based defense technology contractor. And here in this field, it's very important that the system operates reliably. So what is Amplify? With Amplify, we commercialized our data management systems and our analytics systems that are already in place in order to manage the large amount of image data and in order to extract information out of this. So Amplify collects, manages, and leverages all type of such data. And this includes inventory, cataloging of the data, and also automated analytics, such as damage detection, vegetation encroachment, understanding if there's vegetation coming into certain corridors, and also identifying specific types of components at assets. Yeah, and this technology that we include in Amplify is built on our commercial off-the-shelf technology that is in place also for decades. One of them is Envy. Envy, our image processing software, working with all types of data, image data, LiDAR data, radar data. And here you can see, for example, in this figure, point cloud data where that has been classified in order to understand the power lines, the conductors, and vegetation that is encroaching into the corridor of the power lines. And also machine learning is an important component, deep learning in particular. With this technology, we can automatically detect damages at insulators, such as bird's nests here, for example, or damaged insulator in this figure. How does this work? The first step is typically that data needs to be collected. This can be from a helicopter equipped with a camera, with a multispectral camera, an infrared camera, a thermal camera, a LiDAR sensor, a corona sensor. The data is uploaded in the system, is processed, analyzed, and then answers are derived from this data. So we can work here with all type of data and extract information of the data. For example, out of image data, we have trained deep learning models that can detect specific type of components, such as a transformator, an insulator, and conductor. Also damages at these components. Out of LiDAR data, we can understand vegetation encroachment, and all of this maintenance. And data can come from all different types of platforms, as said. What is also of interest is not only working with data collected by utilities, but also working with satellite data from monitoring services. Thinking here of particularly SAR services, or radar services, to understand subsidence, and I will show you an example later, or macro-scale vegetation monitoring, using, for example, Sentinel-2 data to understand if vegetation is encroaching into certain corridors at a macro scale to have a closer look with more high-resolution data in this area later. Yeah, and the analytics that we have implemented is the damage inspection, anomaly detection, the vegetation encroachment, and also location improvement. Often the known sets are not well mapped, and with that automatic approaches, we can improve and conflate the position of, for example, power poles and certain assets. Yeah, to then disseminate and act, and I showed you the examples before, infrastructure monitoring, change detection, predictive analytics, also modeling on a longer term, life cycle modeling. Here we can provide valuable input data. How does Amplify look like? Here you have a map view, and a map view with power poles, you see green dots, yellow dots, and red dots. Actually, analytics have been driven on the data that was collected at these power poles, and anomalies are shown. So you see yellow areas where a warning is, red areas where action needs to be taken because something is not in order. And also on the vegetation encroachment, here vegetation is encroaching into the power lines. Yeah, but the most valuable information at the end is the report in order to generate work orders, for instance, a summary of the anomalies that have been detected. Avian covers that are missing at certain poles, vegetation that is encroaching, or also the power pole that is beyond a certain lean angle. We are strong in image analytics, and deep learning is part of that. Trained deep learning models are running in the back. Once the data is uploaded, once the image data is uploaded, it will be analyzed, a report will be generated, and this figure is showing you examples on the deep learning model on that it is trained on, such as flashes at insulators, birds' nests that has been found, contaminated conductors, or broken insulators. Yeah, I spoke about services running in the back. Not sure how familiar you are with SAR, with radar. This is a slide of our partner SARMAP. SARMAP is the team that is developing the SARscape algorithms that are running in NV SARscape. When you monitor SAR data over time and apply interferometric techniques, it's possible to measure surface elevation changes at a millimeter scale. And here in this figure, it's from October 2014 to March 2018, at a scale from 0 to 15 millimeters, we see a slight uplift over time at this specific position close to that power plant. And the accuracy is also in a millimeter scale. So we can monitor over time if something is happening on the ground that is anomalous, and then create alerts when such is happening. And something like that can be also implemented in such an environment. Yeah, at Harris, we are on the analytics side, on the image side. We also sell data, image data, SAR data, and other data. We partnered with major data providers such as Digital Globe, Airbus, and Planet in order to provide the data that is needed for operational monitoring in the back. And this can be also data which is terrestrial data, terrestrial image data, such as CCTV cameras. Here this is an example along streets. We incorporated here deep learning and image analytic technologies in another product which we call Helios. Here image data is analyzed to understand the weather condition at streets. So this is used, for example, by the US highway company to provide alerts when there are anomalous weather conditions. And such technology is also incorporated in Amplify to understand real-time weather situations, particularly during storms or after storms, to remediate the situation. Yeah, and how does Amplify integrate in utilities operation systems? Again, Amplify is a system that manages and that analyzes image data. So images are captured by the utilities from a helicopter, from a UAV, or also terrestrial images, and satellite services can run in the back. Images are analyzed in order to provide insights. And these insights are then fed among from other sources in the central asset data warehouse, in the central database system, to then, and this data is then used by other systems of the utilities ecosystem, such as a GIS repository from S3, for instance, work management. Again, Amplify can provide here information if vegetation is encroaching into corridors and it must be cut back. So the vegetation can be located where it is and that can be quantified. Or the asset management. And this can be also predictive modeling, so understand the life cycle of a set components. Here, Amplify can provide valuable insights of the components that assets are composed of, for example, a transformator, which manufacturer is the transformator, and when it was built. Okay, I see the time is running fast. To summarize, the significant potential in using image data, image analytics, to improve efficiency in operative maintenance at utilities, with the key benefits of optimizing costs, improving safety, ensure reliability, and increase the customer satisfaction. In terms of technology, we have implemented components to detect damages, to identify assets, to manage vegetation encroachment, also services, satellite-based services for land displacement monitoring, for instance, for using CCTV cameras networks for understanding the real weather situation on the ground. And at the end, I would like to show you a short video to better understand what I have speaking about. Just wondering if it is starting here, or if I need to, it's starting. So the first step is typically to upload data, image data, that was captured by the system, that was captured by the utilities. Here's the images of insulators, all other type of images. These are uploaded to the system, processed in the back, and after it has been processed, it produces a map view and also a report. Here in the map view, you can see red dots, alerts, anomaly has been found, vegetation encroachment in these areas. Here we have a normal condition. We can click on it, look at the data. You see here components have been detected by the deep learning, insulators, it understands they're insulators, also other types of analytics, no water have been found nearby. The pole angle of that power pole is within within the area it has to be. And transformator has been found. So again, deep learning to understand which components compose such type of a set. And now we go to another area where there was a damage, an alert. An insulator is broken. Deep learning has found broken insulators here. This is also summarized in a report, along with other analytics that have been driven in the back. No nests have been detected. Again, these are all analytics that are running in the back. Here, for example, an insulator is flashed. And as deep learning is an iterative process, it's just to show you for purpose that some damages have not been found, and that, of course, it is possible to relabel information to tell the system what type of damage is here. So we add here that this component has been flashed to improve the deep learning system. Okay, and now we go to another area. This was image data. Again, the value of image data is damage detection, asset inspection. The value of LiDAR data, that is typically also collected by utilities, is on the vegetation monitoring side. You see here point cloud data that has been collected by the utilities with a helicopter, here by a customer in the US. Analytics that have all automatically been driven in the back is that the lean angle of the power pole is within guidelines. No vegetation is here encroaching, but also other analytics, if the power pole can be easily be accessed by a street nearby. So we have a terrain profile here, very helpful for groups that are tasked with getting the things in place. A link to Google Earth, again, a customer in the US. These are US-based assets. Video is finishing about 1 minute. The image view, same power pole. Here, deep learning found an avian cover is missing. avian cover is missing. Two avian cover has been found at the other insulators here. And it has been found it's difficult to access the pole from the street. And I think that that was the video. So thank you for your attention. And if you have questions, happy to answer them. We have also stand the booth outside, still there till tomorrow, 1 o'clock. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Bueno, y con esto ya es la última ponencia de esta tarde. Agradeceros a todos el haber estado en esta, haber elegido esta sala en vez de otras y haber aguantado estoicamente hasta ahora. Muchas gracias.
The science of wear.